Yeah, thanks, guys. I think we all know that a huge part of South Africa's heritage is our incredible wildlife, unsurpassed, in fact. And having recently celebrated World Rhino Day, it is now important to remember that we must all step up our campaign to preserve our wildlife heritage. And a new documentary film called Horn attempts to do just that. Let's get a little snippet.
People are forced into this out of circumstances of that they find themselves in. No money, no job, no prospect of a job. And suddenly the prospect of being involved without any risk to yourself, just by a tip-off, it's very difficult for a person to turn away from that. And so we need to look at the socio-economic, not just the economics of this, we need to look at the social aspect of it.
Sure, well, I think your heart probably also skipped a beat. Looking at the footage, it's incredibly scary to think of what our rangers go through every day in protecting our precious resource, being rhinos. Now, joining us via Skype is the filmmaker himself, the man behind Horn, the woman behind Horn, Dr. Raina Marie Loader, to chat about the incredible film. Dr. Loader, thank you so much for joining us. Well, instead of the usual pointing fingers, let's arrest the bad guys approach, your film looks at long-term solutions and helps people really understand why poaching is happening in the first place. Please tell us a little bit about the film.
What was particularly important to me was to present a different side to the rhino poaching issue, because if you look at kind of the stuff that's been coming out, it was very much focused either on what's happening to the animal itself, which is important, of course, or on the poachers and how to catch them. But nobody was really like kind of talking about kind of the social conditions out of which this crisis has developed. And that's very much what Horn is focused on, like looking at the areas around rhino poaching hotspots, so as to try and determine what factors create the perfect climate for this crisis to grow, really.
Well, it's a crisis that involves a huge amount of risk and, of course, tremendous danger for those involved. And your film takes an inside look at the lives of game rangers themselves, putting their lives on the line to protect our rhinos. What is life like for them in a snapshot?
For the people working on the ground, it's scary on a daily basis. It's a hard life. It really is. I mean, they're not only confronted by poachers, but they're also confronted by wild animals. And in most cases, they're in big five reserves and parks. It's not a comfortable life. I mean, they have to sleep in the bush, in tents, close to each other, winter, summer, cold, heat. It's a particular kind of life which people have to choose, and if they do, they are very, very brave to do so, because not every person is cut out to do so. And as we also find out while we were following these monitors during just the training, they haven't even been deployed yet. Some of them give up the training just because it's too intense. The training itself already is very hardcore.
I think we can scarcely imagine just how difficult it must be. And your film takes a very hard, long look at the state of poaching in South Africa. You know, pulling no punches, how bad is it right now in your mind?
Well, I think we're at a critical stage. 2014 is really the tipping point for the rhino population, because if we don't curb the poaching rate as it is at the moment, the poaching rate would exceed the birthing rate. And if you just do the maths, that means extinction for a species. It's not just about the conservation of this animal. It's linked to so many other direct problems in our country, as well as our history from 20 years ago. So I would say we're at a very critical stage.
Well, it seems like a rather daunting, if not overwhelming, task. Are you still optimistic that we can turn things around? And what can we do? What can I do as the average person to help preserve our rhinos?
Talking is a powerful weapon, I think, and the average person who's not in the field and who's not walking with the rhino, they too have a role to play in this, and that is Facebook, donations to certain charities that they know are ethical and do actually do the jobs that they say, and just keep on raising awareness and thinking about the people and the rhinos. And if we manage to solve this crisis, I mean, again, South Africa can be an example to the world, because we will be the country that managed to keep our rhinos. Most of the African countries have lost their rhinos, other than South Africa. So we can be an example again to what it means to make the right decisions, the ethical decisions. And I would definitely say never give up hope.
I love that. Never give up hope. Thank you so much, Dr. Loader. So much for joining us on the show and for the work that you are doing. We applaud it. Helping to preserve one of South Africa's greatest heritages, our rhino. It's something that we can all do. To find out how you can get involved or to follow the progress of Horn, check out our Facebook page for all of the details. This is an opportunity for all of us to protect our African, not just South African, heritage. Right, time now to find out what is coming up in the next stanza of our Heritage Day special. Ilana is very excited, so it must be awesome.